लक्ष्मी फ्रॉम बीएससी एमपीसीएस फाइनल ईयर फ्रॉम टीटीडब्ल्यू ओडीसी देवरकोंडा डिग्री कॉलेज. सो टुडे आई वांटेड टू टेक सेमिनार ऑन कंप्यूटर साइंस सब्जेक्ट. सो इन दिस कंप्यूटर साइंस आई वांटेड टू टेक टॉपिक ओब्स. सो टुडे आवर कॉन्सेप्ट इज ओब्स, ऑब्जेक्टिव ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज. बिफोर दैट वी वांटेड टू लर्न अबाउट अ कंप्यूटर. वॉट इज मीन बाय कंप्यूटर हियर? I want to tell definition of the computer. Computer means nothing but it is an electronic device. It is an electronic device which can accept the input and then display the output results to the users. Here, users means nothing but people. Means who are using the system is known as users. So finally, computer means nothing but that it is an electronic device which can accept the input and display the output results. Okay, next, fundamentals of computer means nothing but we wanted to know as a computer student, we wanted to know that about fundamentals in computer means nothing but computer architecture here. It is also called as components of a computer system. So, in the components of a computer system means nothing but a computer architecture consists of six types. Here, in this, first one is input, and second one is output, and third one is CPU, and fourth one is control unit, and fifth one is ALU, and sixth one is memory unit. So, here, first one, input. So, what is meant by input? Input means nothing but giving the data or instructions or information to the system by users is known as input. And second one is output. Output means system is taking input which is given by the users, and the system is giving reply by in the form of output, means displaying the result on the screen by using through printers, display screens. Printers means by in the form of hard copy, it will giving the output to the users. And also display screens. In the form of display screens, it is giving the means system giving the output to the users. And also in this input, users are giving through using properties here means by using keyboard, and also scanner giving the information or data or instructions to the system by using these properties. Nextly, what is meant by CPU? CPU means here central processing unit. CPU is known as the brain of the computer system. Without this, we can't imagine this components of a computer system. So CPU is known as brain of the computer system. And also, what is meant by control unit here? Control unit means nothing but I am controlling the operations. And controlling unit is also known as a controlling operations. Next, arithmetical logical unit. Before you understand the control unit, we want to understand about the arithmetical logical unit. Arithmetical logical unit means nothing but it will. Before understanding control unit, firstly we want to understand about the ALU. ALU means here nothing but arithmetical logic unit. Arithmetical logic unit means nothing but in this we are using operator. Operators means nothing but plus, minus, addition, multiplication, division, etc. So this ALU was controlled by this control unit. So this is known as control unit. And memory. Memory means nothing but memory unit means nothing but here it is storing the data or information. It's known as a memory. And also when the user want required, then it was giving that data to the users. So this is known as memory. Finally, we are completed that about the fundamentals of computer, means the basics of computer we are completed. Nextly, when we wanted to learn the computer science, so many languages are there in market. So firstly, for example, I want to tell that some examples are C, C++, Java, Python, .NET, etc. So many are there. In that, C language was developed by Dennis Ritchie in 1970. Okay, and also in C++. C++ is also a programming language, and C++ is also one of the programming language. And C++ is object-oriented programming language. So it was designed by John Skorstrup at Bell Labs of USA in 1980. So this is the C++, and in that C++ there are so many topics over there. In that I wanted to choose, I chosen that OOPS concept. So today I wanted to take seminar on OOPS concept. So OOPS, what is meant by OOPS here? OOPS means nothing but an object oriented programming language. So in that OOPS there are seven types. First one is class, and second one is object, third one is data abstraction, fourth one is data encapsulation, and fifth one is inheritance, sixth one is polymorphism, and seventh one is dynamic binding. First one is here in the OOPS. So in the OOPS concept, first we have to discuss about the class. Here, what is meant by class? Class means nothing but a group of objects, is known as a class. Before discussion of class, we want to discuss about the object. So here, what is meant by object means the property which has a state, behavior, and identity. Having the state, behavior, and identity to a property is known as an object. Means, example, if you take a pen, means having the state, it has the state and also behavior, means how it is working, and also it has having the identity, means it is red color, a blue color, a pink color, this is the identity. So having these kinds means state, behavior, and identity to a property, these types is known as object. So class means nothing but a group of objects means having the same format is known as a class. Next, data abstraction. What is mean? Third one is data abstraction. What is meant by data abstraction? In that, what is meant by data? Data means nothing but an here piece of information is known as data. Means in our daily language we can use information, but in computer language we are using that information means nothing but an data. So data means nothing but an here piece of information. Next thing, abstraction. So here, what is meant by abstraction? Means nothing but an hiding the implementation details and showing only functionality to the users. Means nothing but an, first of all, I want to say one example. That is, when we are sending the SMS to our friends, firstly, I want to send one SMS to my friend. So that SMS, when I typed that SMS and I am sent to that my friend, that is reached to destination, means she will take care of that SMS. Means in that internal processing is we are not seeing, only SMS is reached or not we are checking. So that is known as a data abstraction, means hiding the implementation details. What was going internal processing we are not seeing, only SMS is reached or not, that was seen by users. So that is known as a data abstraction, means only hiding the implementation details. Internal processing is hiding, only showing functionality, means what was going on, only output only seen by the users. So that is known as data abstraction. And here, data encapsulation. Data encapsulation. Encapsulation means nothing but hiding the data. So this is known as a data encapsulation. Nextly, inheritance. Inheritance. Inheritance means nothing but here, one class is allowed to inherit the features of another class. Means one class is giving permissions to another class to take the methods, fields, and properties from that class. So because of that reason, this is called as inheritance. Means one class is giving permissions to another class. So giving permissions means this class is known as parent class, a super class, a base class, and the another class is receiving from that parent class, means taking all the properties and the fields and the methods from that above class, means from that parent class. So because of that reason, this is called as a child class or subclass or derived class. So this is known as inheritance. permissions to another class. This is known as inheritance. So in that inheritance, there are the three words we wanted to discuss. That is class. What is meant by class? And what is meant by superclass? And what is meant by subclass? So what is meant by class? Already we know group of objects. Group of objects is known as class. Already we know. Nextly, what is meant by superclass here? Superclass means a nothing but giving permissions to another class. Means giving all the properties, classes and methods and fields to the another class is known as superclass. And receiving means taking all the properties, fields and methods from the parent class is known as a child class. Means subclass. This is also known as derived class. So these are the three types we discussed. So in that inheritance, there are five types. First one is single inheritance, and second one is multi-level inheritance, and third one is multiple inheritance, and the fourth one is hierarchical inheritance, and fifth one is hybrid inheritance. In that, first we want to discuss about single inheritance. So here, what is meant by single inheritance? So here, what is meant by single inheritance? Single inheritance means nothing but having one parent class and having only one child class. Means nothing but so here, what is meant by single inheritance? Single inheritance means nothing but having only one parent class, means one super class, and having only one child class, means nothing but having only one subclass. This is known as single inheritance. Means here A is known as super class and B is known as subclass. This subclass is taking all the properties and methods and fields from this super class, means this parent class. Because of that reason, this is known as taking, means always taking the properties from the parent class is known as a subclass or derived class or child class. And it was giving, always giving permissions to this child class, means subclass. Because of that reason, this is known as a super class. So this is known as single inheritance. And the second one is multi-level inheritance. What is meant by multi-level inheritance here? Means having base class, child class, and child class is also giving properties to the another child class. This is known as multi-level inheritance. Means here, see, A is known as a super class and B is known as a subclass. So this is also known as A is also known as a super class or parent class or base class. And B is also called as a subclass or a child class or derived class. Because B is taking all the properties and fields and methods from this parent class A. So because of that reason, B is called as a subclass. After that, B is giving fields, methods and properties what are taken from A, and B also having its own properties, fields and methods. This both combination, this B is giving its properties, fields and methods to its child C. So this is also known as a subclass. Why? Because it was taking from B and B is giving to C. Because of that reason, this is known as superclass. This is also known as a superclass because it is giving the properties, fields and methods to C and it is taking the properties, fields and methods from A. It is taking, because of that reason this is known as a subclass, means child class. After that it was giving its properties, fields and methods to C. Because of that reason this is called as a parent class, means nothing but a superclass. Nextly, C was taking only properties, fields and methods from B. So because of that reason this is known as a subclass and it was not giving to anyone. So it does not have any child. So because of that reason this is only called as a subclass and not called as a superclass. So B is taking the properties and methods and fields and B is giving the properties, fields and methods. So because of that reason B is called as multiple inheritance. Means here there are two base classes and only one child class. Means this child class is taking its properties, speeds and methods from its parent classes both A and B. So because of that reason this is known as a multiple inheritance. There are more than one base class. Means here A is one of the base class and B is also one of the base class. And here C is only one child class. And it was taking properties, fields and methods from A and B parents. So these two are called as super classes because it was giving its properties, fields and methods to its child C. And it was taking its properties, fields and methods from its parents A and B. So because of that reason it was called as subclass. So this is known as multiple inheritance. Nextly, we are going to discuss about hierarchical inheritance. So here what is meant by hierarchical inheritance? Multiple inheritance is completed after that hierarchical inheritance. In that hierarchical inheritance, there is only one parent class, means having only one parent class and having two child class, means having two subclasses. Means here one super class means one parent class giving its properties, fields and methods to its childs like B and C. And B and C means these two child classes means subclasses taking their properties, fields and methods from A, its super class. So this type of process is known as this type of inheritance is known as a hierarchical inheritance. After that, hybrid inheritance. So here, what is meant by hybrid inheritance? Hybrid inheritance means nothing but combination of, means mixture of any two inheritances. Means we have to mix single inheritance, multi-level inheritance, or multi-level inheritance, or multiple inheritance, hierarchical inheritance, or single inheritance and hierarchical inheritance, or single inheritance and multiple inheritance. Here I mixed that hierarchical inheritance up to here. After that, next thing I mixed that multiple inheritance up to here. So this is the combination of hierarchical inheritance and multiple inheritance. In this, here A is a parent class. It was giving its properties, fields and methods to this child classes. Means these two are called as subclasses. And here A is known as a super class, means parent class. It was giving its properties and fields and methods to these B and C child classes. And here B and C is taking its properties and methods from A. So because of that reason B and C is known as a subclasses. So this type of inheritance is known as a hierarchical inheritance. Nextly, B, C, D. Here in this we see that in more than one parent class is there. So because of the reason B and C and D, this type of inheritance is known as multiple inheritance. In this multiple inheritance, B and C is known as a parent classes, means nothing but super classes. And B and C is giving its properties, fields and methods to child class. It's a child class D. After that, D is receiving its properties, fields and methods from B and C. So because of that reason, B and C is also known as super class because it was giving the properties, fields and methods to its subclass, means child class. So because of that reason, it was super class. Here B and C is known as taking the properties, fields and methods from its parent class, means nothing but an A. After that, it was giving the properties and methods and fields to its child class D. So because of that reason, it was taking properties, fields and methods, and it was giving properties, fields and methods. Because of that reason, this is called as an intermediary class. B and C is known as intermediary class. So intermediary class. So because of that reason, this is known as a hybrid inheritance. This mixture is known as a hybrid inheritance. In this inheritance, there are five types. Is there? First one is a single inheritance. Single inheritance means having only one one parent class and one child class is known as single inheritance, and second one is multi-level inheritance. In that multi-level inheritance, having one parent class and having one child class, and one child class is giving a child class is also giving its properties and fields to that child class. Means it behave as a base class and also derived class. One child class will be behave as a like a base class and derived class. So because of that reason, this is known as an intermediary class. In this way, this is known as a multi-level inheritance. And after that, multiple inheritance. Multiple inheritance means here nothing but having a two parent classes, means more than one parent class. After that, having only one child class is known as multiple inheritance. After that, hierarchical inheritance. What is meant by hierarchical inheritance here? Means having only one super class and having two child class. Means this is giving its properties, fields and methods to its two children. Only one parent class and having two children is known as hierarchical inheritance. Next, hybrid inheritance. Hybrid inheritance means mixture of two inheritances. Mixture of any two inheritances. You can mix a single inheritance, multi-level inheritance, or multi-level inheritance, multiple inheritance, or multiple inheritance, or hierarchical inheritance. Your wish. Here I mixed that hierarchical inheritance and multiple inheritances. So mixture of any two higher inheritances is known as hybrid inheritance. So this is known as a brief explanation about inheritance. This is the one of the part in OOPS, means object oriented programming language. This is the fifth point. So inheritance means finally one class is allowed to inherit the futures of another class, means it will giving the permissions to another class. This is known as inheritance. So finally, next sixth one, polymorphism. This is also one of the part in OOPS, object oriented programming languages. Polymorphism. Polymorphism means here, poly means many. Morphism means forms. Polymorphism means many forms. Polymorphism means here, many forms. So here, polymorphism, I will tell one example for this polymorphism. So a woman can form many roles. Means many forms means, so many forms means here, a woman can play like a mother role, wife role, sister role, like that. This is known as this is one of the example for polymorphism. Poly means many, morphism means forms here. Polymorphism means many forms, means many roles we can play. Next, dynamic binding. What is mean by dynamic binding? Dynamic binding is also one of the part in this OOPS, object oriented programming languages. So dynamic binding means here link, means here linking one object to another object. Object means nothing but having state, behavior and identity. So that is known as behave object. So dynamic binding means here binding, we are binding, means we are linking one object to another object. That is known as dynamic binding. So we have completed that about, finally we have completed that about OOPS concept. Means here OOPS means finally object oriented programming language. This is one of the concept in C++ language. C++ is also one of the object oriented programming language. So it is one of the concept. OOPS is one of the concept in C++. So in that we have discussed about what is meant by class. Class means nothing but group of objects, we have discussed. Next, object. Object means nothing but having state, behavior and identity. Yes, finally next, data abstraction. Data abstraction means hiding the implementation details and showing only functionality to the users. Yes, we are completed. Finally next, fourth one is data encapsulation, means just hiding the data. After that, inheritance. Inheritance means we are completed, giving permissions to another class. In that, five types we are completed. After that, we are completed polymorphism. Polymorphism we